School's out, the summer holidays are well and truly underway, and there are some big events attracting thousands in the East this weekend.
The first Harwich Power Festival will see 30,000 people watching music and powerboats over 2 days.
The motor theme continues at Silverstone on Sunday for the World Superbike Championships, where another 35,000 will be watching.
The Cambridge Folk Festival got underway last night. That should pull in 30,000 visitors over 4 days.
While a new music festival, Sonisphere, will rock Knebworth with 35,000 music lovers.
Well, we're always told how much these events actually benefit the local communities, but how much do they really make?
And what impact do they have? We have reporters at all those events, beginning with Martin Stew at Knebworth.
6 stages, 7 kilometres of scaffold and 18,000 metres of hair, Sonisphere at Knebworth is ready to rock. But these events don't just make music.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
If we have large events going on in the region, then that's great. That's a reason for people to come. And then while they're here, hopefully they'll find some other things to do and stay for a little bit longer, 2 or 3 days maybe. And that all helps the local economy and the local businesses.
The tourist industry was worth £5.1 billion to the region's industry last year, with some of the larger events pulling in huge sums individually. For example, the V Music Festival was worth £8.2 million to the Chelmsford area, the South End Air Show earned £3.2 million, while the recent Charles Darwin exhibition at Cambridge's Fitzwilliam Museum made £1.6 million for the area.
For every pound that is spent here today, £28 will be spent within the local economy, which is an astounding figure and just shows how important such festivals are here in Hertfordshire.
So the fact that festivals like this exist and are flourishing, I think is very important for the music business, and it's important that regionally, you know, I think people are aware of that and support them and are interested in music.
Well, it may be quiet out there at the moment, but in just a few hours, tens of thousands will be filling that field as Gary Newman and Alice Cooper take to this stage as part of the Sonisphere Festival. But of course, this is one of just many of the UK's biggest events happening this weekend right here in our region.
Silverstone for the British round of the World Superbike Championships, the third leg of what they describe as their triple crown of events this year, following the British Motor GP and the British Motor Racing Formula One. And given the uncertainty over Silverstone's future last year, those events have helped cement it as the number one draw for British motorsport.
The new 17-year deal we got on the Grand Prix is really a catalyst for the future for not just Silverstone, but this region.
At the Cambridge Folk Festival, organisers say they're expecting over 10,000 people each day here in the grounds of Cherry Hinton Hall. But the police say they're maintaining a very low-key presence at this event.
We've got about 7 officers here at the moment, and regards our remit, we just want to make sure that people know that we're here, we're walking around, we're integrating as much as we can, chatting to people, and it's nice for them to know that we're here so that they can come and approach us if they need to.
This is a huge weekend for Harwich, both in terms of numbers. There'll be 50 massively powerful boats dashing around on the bay out there behind me over the weekend. And the businessman who set up this enterprise says that he's done it because he wants to regenerate this deprived corner of Essex.
I saw powerboat racing something like 5 years ago, and I said then this would be ideal in a natural amphitheatre like we've got here at Dover Court Bay, and hence we've been working on this for 18 months to get this to get it here today.
Whether it's established events like the Cambridge Folk Festival or new ones on our region's calendar, these big tourist events are increasingly big business, not to mention great fun. Martin Stew, Anglia News, Hertfordshire.
Friday evening, sir.
Yeah. The Cambridge Folk Festival. It's been running since 1965 and I've never been. That's terrible, isn't it? I'd really love to. Yeah. There's loads about it in the Anglia archive.
Well, if you want to see how it looked 25 years ago, there's a report on our website. That's at itv.com/Anglia. Also, there is the latest behind-the-scenes report from the Anglia allotment. We've seen it and it's well worth
a
view,
one.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Now, on last night's programme, we told you about the 7-year-old child prodigy whose paintings were expected to sell for thousands of pounds.
People had come from all over the world to buy Kieran Williamson's work. They went on sale at 9 this morning. Kate Pratt was there as well.
They came, they camped. Did you sleep there last night or did you sleep in your car?
Oh, in the car last night. It was pouring.
point with me. The first night, we were all together under umbrellas and stuff, so we got to know each other quite well then.
The locals in town have been very supportive, coming out, bringing chairs and stuff to eat, and it's been amazing.
Once you have this envelope,
and then they bought.
Hello, number one, yes. Thanking you.
With buyers from America, Kenya, Tokyo, it appears Kieran's work has genuine worldwide appeal.
It's been well worth it. I'm really, really pleased. Really pleased.
Can I be cheeky and ask exactly how much you've just spent?
£22,710. Oops.
Probably around £13,000.
The buzz in here today is just fantastic. So, and to actually see the paintings in the flesh is, well, they're just tremendous.
There's some lovely colours in it. Very nice.
The boy who told his parents he was going to be world famous stood rather bemused as buyers snapped up his pictures.
Right, you've got that one as well, OK?
Are you a bit overwhelmed by it all?
Yeah, I am.
Mm-hmm. Well, Kieran has managed to break his own record. 33 paintings sold in 22 minutes and they've made just under £150,000.
The money is something that we try not to think about. You know, it will all be kept for his future. It's a fantastic opportunity to set him up financially. We've tried to keep the prices down. You know, it's just phenomenal that people have come as far as they have to purchase his work. It's lovely.
Unlike other landscape artists such as Constable and Turner, Kieran will profit from his talent in his lifetime. But it'll be a few more years before he can celebrate his extraordinary success with anything stronger than orange juice. Kate Prout, Anglia News, Holt in Norfolk.
Cheers. Well done.
He looked so small in the middle of all that chaos, didn't he?
He did. It's still utterly brilliant, though. He's just like that woman said, £22,000. Oops.
Now, next tonight, a wanted appeal. Do you know this cuddly toy?
It was left behind at a cafe in Thorpeness on the Suffolk coast, and knowing there's a distraught child somewhere, there must be, look at it, either locally or a holidaymaker, the owners have set up a Facebook page to reunite them. Laura Burns has the story now.
This seaside tea room's no stranger to visitors, but this one has stayed here longer than most. He was found on the doorstep a week and a half ago and has still not been claimed. He blends in very well and is popular with customers. But staff here know his real owner must be missing him. So they've launched a Facebook page to find them, which includes a series of holiday-style snaps.
We even had somebody on his face page from Portugal just now, and from Bulgaria. No, he's definitely gone global, so we very much hope, as I say, if they're here on holiday, that you know, we can reunite him. We will send him registered post wherever he has to go.
Of course, that could be anywhere.
Now, staff here have grown quite fond of him and have even affectionately called him Meerkat. But they're also keen to reunite him with his owner, because, of course, not even an extended holiday is as much fun if you don't have your best friend to share it with you. Not that Meerkat's been short of attention.
We think it's quite a weird meerkat.
It's got a pink nose.
It's got a pink nose, which isn't normal. They normally have brown nose. And it's a funny colour.
He may be unusual looking, but he's definitely been loved. And staff hope their efforts will pay off. Because if they don't, it may be down to little Meerkat. He'll have to try and track them down himself. Laura Burns, Anglia News, Thorpeness in Suffolk.
And if you know whose it is, the Facebook page or Jonathan and Becky at ITV.com.
Right, let's catch up with the weather now for the weekend. Here's Amanda.
Well, if you're at one of our region's events this weekend, have a good one.
Have a great time. We'll see you on Monday.
Yeah, see you then. Bye.
All the best. Bye-bye.